I said get out here now. Don't make me get you out by force.
Okay, fine, whatever. You found us, hooray. Darn it. We were just having a little bit of fun.
Now that I have finally found you, I challenge you into a rematch.
Let's do this, boys. Bad wham.
Knife stab.
Tazazap.
No, 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 no. I can't believe I lost again.
That's right, You have no match against us. Now give up your plan because the police are coming soon.
No, this isn't over yet. I still have this sucker with me that will teach you a lesson. Behold, the second secret box. I have stolen it from a horde of cops and soldiers who found it in Big Green Beach, and I will use this to destroy you. But first, hand over the golden horseshoe.
No. You will have to go after us to see who has the golden horseshoe. Oh, but who?
Darn it. Who should I go after first? All right. Enough running. Now fight me like a beast.
I can run whatever I want. Now bring it. Incoming Warhammer. I win. R. But double too bad for you because I don't have the golden horseshoe. Now I'm going to run.
Oh great! A decoy! So Cotton Belt SD40T doesn't have one, huh? Now who should I get next?
Well, well, you think you can beat me? Let's see how you think if I have the secret box or not. Disgusting beer drink attack.
No, I am drunk. I am too drunk to attack.
Golf stick attack. Well, you're just out of luck again because I don't have the box either.
Oh, not again. There's only one dude left and he should have that box. Alright, I know you're the one who has the golden horseshoe. Surrender now.
I will never surrender to you. Stun baton attack.
Oh crap, I got paralyzed. I can't move.
Hatchet attack.
No, 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 no. I can't believe I lost again and again. Harem.
Ding, ding, ding. You found the right guy. I have a secret horseshoe, but I will still never give it to you.
No, 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 no. I'm surrounded again. Wait a second. I still have the other secret box. Before I reveal it, let me tell you why and how I became a sticklet. Here I go. Many months ago, I was used to be that handsome look before I became a sticklet. I was handsome, wearing real clothes, and even having glasses on. I was so smart. But, however, some of the people were making fun of me for no darn reason. They just point at me and laugh. Even pretty girls and sport boys. It really hurts me and I kept telling the teachers. When I do, and the teacher scolds the kids, they get ticked off at me and made the horde laugh even worse for their revenge. I was getting tired of talking to the teachers about the laughing, so instead, I go beat up the people who dare laugh at me. Every time I do some payback, I make one of the laughers cry and laugh at them back, but sometimes teachers caught me doing this and I get in trouble. Every time I harm a laugher, the teacher always caught me doing it and I get in trouble. I've been sent to the principal's office every time I beat up a person who laughs at me. and I kept getting detentions and suspensions. And then the teachers call my parents, and I get grounded. Time passes on a little, and people still make fun of me. So instead of beating them up, I nod at them and say dirty words to them. But I also get in trouble with that as well. That chaos kept going and going, and I did revenge over and over again. And when I do, I get caught and get in trouble many times. The principal kept calling my parents about my actions I have done. So many actions. I got expelled from school, and I got grounded until I get a new school. And I'm never allowed to do anything I want but staying in my bed being bored, said. But now I realized, I was thinking to blame the students at my school. I was so mad, I vowed to get my best revenge ever on the people who ruined me. So I revealed the golden snitch, the powerful weapon I received for Christmas when I was little. My first target was my parents. I wanted revenge on them for ruining my life. I trespass at my school, eliminating teachers and students who dare get in my way or who made fun of me that caused me to be kicked out of school. Because that thing is so powerful, I destroyed the whole school for my revenge, and it was a success. But then, I got sent to court, and since execution was illegal, there wasn't another punishment. I was sent to two young women I knew. Their names were Ruby and Remy. They're magical and the ones who put the curse on me for my lesson. And now I turned into a stick person by their spell. There was no way that I can be able to turn back to normal after all the things I've done. The women were too strong. Then they locked me in a cage so I wouldn't be able to escape. I was going to be a stickman forever and ever and never return to normal. And that's how I turned into that. Now you know why I invaded Colossal D's house months ago.
Oh goodness, I'm sorry to hear all that.
Wait, but how did you get here with that UFO?
Perhaps I could tell you that. Listen carefully. While those two foolish women were gone, I found the way to get out of this annoying cage. Then I stole the UFO I found on the street and escaped from those girls. But when I got in the ship, there were robots in there, and they were turned off. So that gave me the chance to take control of them and they started to become mine. I took over their control and now they bow down at my feet and obey my order. So now I'm the boss, and I will have my revenge. But then, one of the cops were talking to a woman named Caitlin and he's asking her to guard the box. But she is busy at the Pokemon League. She was thinking of what ideas she can do. Until she made an idea by asking Colossal D's Dines who have you, Colossal D and your friends, to guard the box from me and my robots. I did steal the golden horseshoe, but I failed. Colossal D, you made a wish that she saw the whole thing you guys did to defeat me and win your quest. And that's how I escaped and how I got the ship and those robots.
Oh, I see. What two interesting stories.
Wait, we're enemies, right? Shouldn't we fight again?
Oh, totally forgot. Now that the story piece break is finally over, time to reveal my ultimate weapon. Three annoying boys, I present you, the legendary wooden staff that uses power and kills curses. Now that I will show you who my new true power. Ha!
Oh no. R must have used his staff to teleport us all. What will happen to us and R? Where are we going? Find out at the next part of Invasion of Secrets, R's Revenge.